Hey y'all, welcome to What Chelsea Eats. Thank you so much for joining me today. I did a grocery haul yesterday. I went to Costco and Trader Joe's. And the purpose of this video is to share with you foods that you can eat if you are struggling with any type of female-related issue, such as polycystic ovarian syndrome, endometriosis, fibroid tumors, ovarian cysts. If you have any of those issues, these foods are foods that can help you tremendously. Anybody can eat these foods, but I'm honing in on those issues because those are the questions that I get often. I also get questions about hair loss and anemia. So if you have those three, if you have any of those, these foods would be good for you as well. So I'm about to cut over to the haul, but before I do, I just want to say thank you so much to all my new subscribers. And if you are new and haven't subscribed, please consider subscribing. Please like the video if you liked it and share it with a friend. Also, if you have any questions, please put your comments below and I will get back with you as soon as I possibly can. Thanks so much and I hope you enjoy the video. Take care. So the first haul you're going to see is my Costco haul. And what I have here are kale greens, organic kale greens. And I usually use these for my smoothies or steamed vegetable dishes, and I also add them to soups. Here is a big fat watermelon. I only bought one watermelon today. And as you guys know, watermelon is my absolute favorite food. So my husband and I are going to chomp on that watermelon this week. Here are my Easy Greens spring mix. I use these for salads as well as smoothies. Next, I have organic baby spinach, and I get 2 to 3 bunches of bananas per week. And what I typically do is we don't eat them all in a week like this. What I do is I like to wait until they ripen so that I can put them into my smoothies. And what I do is wait till they get spotty, and then I get a freezer bag, and then I peel them and then put them in the freezer. Next, I have cucumbers, and what I use the cucumbers for is I either put them in my salad or I use them to dip into hummus or guacamole or salsa. It gives me something to crunch on. I love grapes. Grapes are like my favorite food, but if you're trying to cleanse your body, eat grapes, because grapes are a good cleanser. And also, if you want to know more about cleansing the body with grapes, there is a book called The Grape Cure, which I will link below. I love the book, and it tells you everything that grapes are good for and how grapes have been used to heal certain, or help the body heal certain diseases and conditions. And I'll link that below. Well, celery, usually like to get organic, but I didn't. There was no organic celery at Costco today. And most people will say, you know, you need to get all your fruits and vegetables organic. And I do the best that I can. I'm not a freak about organic. I love organic, but if I can't get it, I don't get it. But I like to have celery on hand because it's another one that you can dip into hummus and guacamole and salsa. But you can also juice celery juice, and if you have digestive issues, celery juice is perfect for that purpose. Mushrooms, oh my goodness, mushrooms are like my favorite thing, especially in soups. And I love to saute, water saute them till they are sort of caramelized, and I like to put them on top of my salads. So this is one of the things that I do with mushrooms. And you can also stuff them, and maybe I'll show a recipe of stuffed mushrooms. We'll see what happens coming up. And here is guacamole. If you don't make guacamole from scratch, this is a good brand to use, because if you look at the ingredients, they're all clean ingredients in this. I don't know if you can even see that. I don't know if I can get that in focus. But the only thing that's in here that might be questionable for people is sea salt. So if you don't eat salt, this would not be a good product for you. Next, I've got coffee. I don't drink coffee, and I believe that if you struggle with female issues, that you should not drink coffee with caffeine in it, because it causes female issues to be a little bit worse. So the reason I have this in my cart is because my husband is an avid coffee drinker, and if he's gonna drink coffee, I'd prefer for him to drink an organic version of coffee, because coffee is one of the most heavily sprayed crops. And so if you have female issues and you have to drink coffee, drink organic coffee. Okay, and this is just an organic mixed vegetables. This is carrots, corn, peas, and green beans. I like having this on hand to like put in soups, or I like to put it, you know, steam it and put it in my steamed vegetable dish or in whatever recipe I'm making. I mean, you just kind of make things up as you go along. You just need to get your vegetables in. And this is one of the products that I like to use. Now, I will not use this in a week. This will probably last about a month. It could last longer. I don't know. We'll see. And I'm trying this. I normally buy organic blueberries, but these are supposed to be certified pesticide-free, and they're wild blueberries. And I use blueberries for my smoothies or whatever kind of desserts I'm making in the evening after dinner. But I'm going to try these for taste. Usually the organic blueberries taste the best. So we'll see what happens. I'll let you know on this one. This one's called Nature's Touch. And organic strawberries. This one is a good one. The strawberries are sweet, and I use these for my smoothies as well, or sometimes I'll use them for, you know, different desserts that I make. Salmon. I don't eat meat products, animal products at all, but it was in my haul because my husband eats salmon. So if you are somebody who's struggling with fibroids, PCOS, endometriosis, and you just have to have animal products in your diet, be sure to buy wild caught and not farm raised. This here is romaine hearts, and this is organic. I liked this package because for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, it was $5. So less than a dollar a head up for this. And I think that's a great deal for organic.
My Trader Joe's haul.
So here we have some parsley. I like to have a bigger head of parsley because I use it to season everything because I love the flavor. But I either use parsley in my smoothies or on top of salads or in my soups because it has a flavor that I just love. And I got a small bag of broccoli flowerettes, and I'm going to use these for my salads. I got a bag of red lentils, and I'm going to use this for a lentil soup. And those lentils, actually, I'll probably have those for a couple weeks. And these, I had one of these. They're called plum cots. I had one of these a couple of weeks ago, and I just fell in love with them. And so we bought 4. And I don't know if that's too many. I don't know if we'll eat them all, but I'm certainly looking forward to trying these. And these are, honestly don't know what these are. Are these peaches, Kenny?
Yeah.
These are peaches, yellow peaches. So we bought 2 of those. This is Trader Joe's Tea Tree Tingle Shampoo. And those of you who have scalp issues, usually people who struggle with feminine issues, they have dandruff or some type of scalp issues. This is a good shampoo to use to help with that. And this, they also have a conditioner that is good for this too. And if you have natural hair with no chemicals in it, it's great because it will help you to detangle your hair easily. And I think this is my absolute favorite hummus. This week I'm not making homemade hummus, and I haven't been making it lately, so this is the one I like to eat. It's really good. It's a horseradish hummus, and I use the celery or the cucumbers to dip in this, and I also put it in my salad. And I've got 2 zucchini here, and I'm gonna make zucchini pasta here for us today for lunch with this. This is pears. These I can't remember what kind of pears these are. I don't remember, but I got 3 of them. So we'll have those for fruit this week as well. Joe's organic tahini. I love tahini because I make this tahini sauce and I put it on absolutely everything. I think I'm going to have to share that recipe with you guys, because if you have trouble eating vegetables because you're not used to the taste and you're like so used to eating McDonald's and Burger King, you know, sometimes vegetables are just going to taste nasty until you get used to them. I mean, that's just the bottom line, because I run into so many people who say, oh, that is so nasty, how can you eat that? And the reality is I understand it. It's because you're not used to it. You're used to eating stimulating foods. So if you can create sauces and dips and stuff like that to put on your vegetables, it makes it a little bit easier to get used to them. Now, though, I can eat a big fat salad and not put any dressing on it, really. Red onion, which I'll use that for salad or something. And then I've got 4 Roma tomatoes. These tomatoes are pretty big. I usually don't buy the Roma, but I was trying to shop on a budget. And then I got a bag of lemons. And, of course, this is for making salad dressings, putting in water, whatever you use lemons for. You can squeeze lemon over your vegetables. That actually helps with the taste of vegetables as well, as you're trying to transition into things tasting better for you. And raw pecans. I forgot what I bought these for, but it's for a specific recipe. But you can eat pecans just as a snack. Like, I mean, don't eat the whole bag, but you know, 1 to 2 ounces, depending on what your situation is. If you're trying to lose weight, less is best, but this is certainly a good healthy fat that you can eat. I got 2 navel oranges, which I forgot what I was making these for. I think just fruit, just to have on hand. And a package of green onions. I put green onions on everything. It's my preference as far as onions are concerned. I like green onions, and garlic is my favorite. And I have 3 limes. I put lime juice all on top of my food all the time. This is probably my favorite thing to do, is to put limes on top of my food. Okay, so I've got garbanzo beans here. I got 4 cans. So garbanzo beans, in case you didn't know, is the same thing as chickpeas. I have coffee, K-cups. I think that's what you call these things. We have a Keurig, and this is what my husband drinks when he is trying to rush to get coffee instead of grinding full beans. So this is a dark roast coffee from Trader Joe's. And here is a green pepper that I am going to use in the spaghetti that I make today for us. And here is tofu. This is the tofu that I like to eat if I'm going to eat tofu. I tried to limit my soy intake, but if I'm going to eat soy, it's going to be organic for sure. And here's my spaghetti sauce that I'm going to make. This is the tomato basil marinara sauce. I love this one. It's seasoned well from Trader Joe's. And I didn't realize that I love olives, and I do. Here they are. Love olives. We go through a jar of olives a week. And I love to have peanut butter, organic peanut butter. It has to be organic because peanut butter is one of the most heavily sprayed crops, along with coffee. And it's also a GMO crop. So you want to get organic as much as possible, and you want to get it with no added sugar and no salt. And last but not least are kidney beans. I always forget to buy kidney beans, and my husband's like, where are the kidney beans? So I've been trying to make a habit of making sure that I have kidney beans in the house. So that's it for the haul, but what I want to do is share with you my receipts. The first receipt is from Costco, and I don't know if you can see that, but the total was $120, and we had a rebate of $46.10, and so we ended up paying $74.05 for this. And like I said, this is not just a week's worth of groceries. Some of these things will last, you know, a few weeks. And this is my receipt from Trader Joe's. And this one was $59 total. And we were out of everything. So, because I traveled last week and we didn't have any food. So, this is sort of an off week. But on average, we spend about $100 a week on groceries.